Hi everyone, good afternoon. Welcome to this session. Greetings from Mercy Technologies. So this session we are taking, as part of our learning experiment. So as I said, this will be the free session. So what will be the agenda for this session? So I will walk through you guys like each and every points, each and every topics, whatever we have promised. So as part of this session, we will see like some of the topics. And after that, we will go with hands-on coding. And finally, I will be introducing the master course. So this will be around 1 hour session. You can say the duration of the session is 1 hour. So like so I'll be walking through you like step by step. So as part of this session, we are going to see about core Java introduction. And this session is mainly for like people who are new to Java or people who are eagerly want to know about the Java. You can say like this is introduction of core Java, or you can say introduction about the Java session. And as part of this, you will be understanding like why we need to use Java programming language, what are the advantages we will get. Along with that, for job seekers, this will be very useful. Like you will be understanding like what Java plays a role in the IT industry. And finally, like we will see how to set the Java environment, how to download the necessary softwares, and we will see how to, go with the example programs. So again, I can say this session is like eye-opener session. So I cannot say in this 1 hour I can teach you Java or complete Java. No. So I can give like overview about the Java. I can give like advantages of Java. And finally, I can help you to download and install the necessary softwares. And we will go with some example programs. Right. So I cannot teach you like for particular topic or something. Right. So that is our plan. That is our agenda as part of today's session. So let's go deeper. So like, what is the issue about the Java? So you guys know that Java is a programming language and it is created by James Gosling. When he was working with the Sun Microsystem, he invented this Java during 1991. And he is known as father of Java programming. And Sun Microsystem, they released JDK 1.0, first version of Java in 1996, right? So current version of Java is JDK 1.5. So, this is the current version. And now Java is owned by Oracle Corporation. Sun Microsystem was acquired by Oracle during 2010, right? So this is the issue about the Java. You can see that Java is invented on 1991. So now we are living at 2021, right? So you can say almost, 30 years, right? So 30 years, Java is running over almost 30 years. This is the brief issue about the Java. And let's see what are the features are available in Java programming. So I will go one by one. I will try to make you guys to understand, all the topics. In case if you guys needed more information, just message me again. So according to that, I will go in depth. So you may wonder like, from the past 30 years, the programming language Java is very popular and still it is sustaining in IT, right? So what will be the reasons? So there are good amount of features are available. Because of this, you can say Java is, still it is sustaining and ruling the IT industry. One is platform independent. What it means, It means when we are developing an application using Java, so consider like I am developing using Windows machine, right? So we are developing the project, right? Then we can run the project in any system. Say for example, you can run the project in Mac or Linux or any flavors of Linux. So it is platform independent, right? So when we are developing our application, what is happening is, so the source code, right? The machine level code, when we are compiling, the source code is converted into bytecode, right? High level code is converted into machine level code. You can say bytecode. Then, at the destination machine, like either, Mac or Linux, right? The JVM, it is, capable of running the bytecode. It can run any bytecode, right? In case if you develop the application in Windows, consider you compiled and you have developed it, and when you are running, the bytecode can able to run in any machine, right? So that's why we are telling the Java is platform independent, right? Java is platform independent because you can develop in any machine and you can run it in any machine. So I will come back to the second point at the last, right? We will go with the third point. So Java is simple, like any other languages. Java is it is a programming language like any other language. Java is very simple because all the things are coming like C, C++ syntax, almost it is simple. And also Java avoids almost all the complex topics. Like in case if you observe in C, we are having pointers, right? It is one of the tedious topic, operator overloading, multiple inheritance, like how to memory management, all those difficult topics, difficult concepts. Java got rid of all the topics and it is very simple. Let the Java internally, it will take care of memory management, it will take care of pointers, all the things it will take care of it. Mainly the memory management. There only we are having very tough thing, right? So it will take care of all the things. So instead, we only, take care of the, programming side, like logic side. So Java is very simple. So it gives the simple syntax. It almost all the topics, like operators, like conditional statements, loops, all are like same like other programming languages like C, C++, Python, right? So it is very simple, right? And the fourth point is it is very secure, right? Compare with other languages, right? Java is secure, you can say, because we are compiling it. You cannot tamper the bytecode, right? So we cannot tamper the bytecode. It is very secured. And whatever we are developing in case of, serialization, suppose you are transferring over the network or you are serializing with the file, all the things. So it cannot be tampered because it is compiled and, compiled code is very well protected, very well secured. And it cannot be tampered. So the fifth point is it is robust. So it means it is reliable, right? So it avoids almost all the syntax error, almost all the things at compile time itself. During compile time itself, we can come to know that what are the errors or issues are there. So runtime, we are getting very less issues, right? That is good actually, because when we are compiling itself, we can come to know what are the issues, what are the things we are getting it, right? So, and we can say it is a multi-threaded. Java is multi-threaded. It means, at concurrently we can try to execute sequence of programs, more than one programs, right? This is mainly to utilize the CPU memory, right? So Java is multi-threaded. So multi-threaded is the good, you know, topic, and it is a good concept. Mainly, you know, it helps the performance wise. It is very good. You know, multi-threaded plays vital role, right? Now, let's see about the second point, object-oriented. This is very, very important. You know, Java is very famous and it is very popular. The main reason behind is it is object-oriented, right? Because in Java, everything is object. Because when we are writing the class itself, we are starting with class, class name, right? So everything is object. So as it is object-oriented, so we can define the functionalities, all the things, and it can be extended in a future in a better way. Instead of rewriting the code again and again, so we can extend it. So under object-oriented, again, you know, it has many topics, right? Like class, objects, polymorphism, inheritance, right? Abstraction. It provides many, you know, features in object-oriented. So all the things you can say, like it is designed as class and objects, right? And, you know, because of this object-oriented feature, you know, there are many advantages we are getting over Java, right? So you can say class and object. Usually inside class, everything will go inside. And object means basically it is an instance of the class, right? In case if you guys want a few details about the class and object, I can take that also. So let's see, at least this class and object, this will give, you know, a little bit of eye opening. So class, we can say it is a template, or we can say it is a blueprint. You know, inside class, we will be defining the logic, right? It does not exist physically. I will give more information when we are seeing the example, right? And by using the class, we can create any number of objects, right? You can say like class is nothing but we are having an employee form. Consider you are going to one company for attending the interview. So they are giving one form, right? They are asking you to fill the details, saying that, hey, what is your ID? And what is your name? What is your current company, right? What is your current company? So this is the template, right? You can say this is the original form. You can say this is the class, right? In plain form, I can say this is the class. So class is not having any physical thing. It is a logical entity. It has all the functionalities, right? It is asking like, what is your ID? What is your name? What is the company? This is called class, right? Class does not exist physically. If you see, hey, what is the data? No, it is not having any data. So now you can ask like, what is the object? By using the class, we can create any number of objects, right? And the object exists physically, and whatever properties we defined in the class, all the things are available in the object. I'll give the example. Say for example, you have this form. Consider you are taking the Xerox copy and you are filling one form saying that, hey, my ID is 100. My name is Mercy. My company is Google, right? This is the object. So what it means? It means whatever you have defined in the class, all the things you are filling it here, right? All the properties we are getting in the object. Object exists physically. Now I'm creating the second object. ID is 200, name is Angel, company is IBM. Again, I'm creating one more object. ID is 300, name is Joseph, company is Apple, right? So this is called, you know, class and object. Now, if you go through the example again, you will be a definition again, you'll be getting more things. Class is a template, right? It is a blueprint. Here we are defining what are the things we want, right? It's a logical entity. But what about object? Object, it basically acquires all the properties from a class, right? It exists physically. It is an instance. It means whatever things we have defined, we have created using that, right? So this is what example, right? In class, usually we define the data members and methods, right? Usually we will be giving like ID, name, and company. We are defining some methods also, right? So this is a non-static variable or instance variable. So what is object? Here we will be using something like this. We are creating the object by using new keyword. This is the very basic introduction about class and object. Okay, let's go it. You'll be asking why I need to learn Java, right? There are many programming languages out there in industry. Why you need to learn Java? What are the advantages in case if I learn the Java? One thing is Java is easy and simple, right? And it is invented on 1991. First version is released on JDK version. First version released on 1995. More than 25 years, Java is ruling the industry, right? And you know, in IT companies, there are many projects are running in Java, right? Because the main thing is Java is a open source, right? So in case of for using Java, you no need to pay the amount. It is open source. So many projects, existing projects are using Java. Main technology is Java. Even upcoming projects are also going to use Java. And as Java is a open source, many frameworks, right? By using Core Java, they have developed many frameworks like Hibernate, Spring, Struts, Spring Boot. There are many frameworks are built on top of Java. These frameworks, again, it plays vital role, right? If any new projects comes, many of them are going with Spring Boot, Hibernate, right? And it is easy to integrate with other open source tools and technologies. Say, for example, you know, there are n number of technologies are there. Maven, Ant, Gradle, Git, Jenkins, Docker, Kubernetes, right? So Java, we can integrate with many tools and technologies, right? So all might be open source, right? So it is for developing Java, any application, right? Any project. So there are ready-made technologies or tools are available. We can easily integrate. So all these are, you know, the advantages. Finally, we can ask, hey, what is the advantage I will get? Right, in case if I learn Java, what is the advantage I will get? One of the question I am getting is, what is open source? Open source is nothing but consider you are inventing something, you are developing something, and you are giving it freely. Source code will be free, so anyone can use that product, and by using that code they can develop. On top of that, they can develop you know, advanced things. If it is not open source, means you can say some of the things like, you know, .NET or, you know, Oracle database, those are not open source. It means in case if you want to use, you need to pay it, right? Open source means you don't need to pay, right? We can go ahead. So now, like, what is the advantage as we individual we are getting by learning Java? So as I said, there are many projects are there, and even upcoming projects also, like, you know, many projects are going to use Java. So if many projects are there, for sure there are more job openings, right? So more job openings are there for fresher, even for experienced. And as I said, it is invented on 1995. I see in my company like 20 years, 25 years experienced, you know, members. They are working in Java. They have started their career in Java. Still, they are sustaining over 20, 25 years. They are working in Java, right? So, and also, like, comparatively, the salary is good for Java developers. More openings are there. Salary also good. You can say, like, for product-based organization, for fresher level itself, they are giving up to from, you know, 8 lakh, from 6 lakh or 8 lakh onwards, right? Some companies, they give up to 12 lakh, like banking companies, right? Like Intuit, right? Wells Fargo. So we can get good salary. even like for experienced candidate, right? In case if you are starting your career in a startup or a service-based organization, after 2 or 3 years, when you are switching it, you can get good number of salary, right? And the job consistency is also there, right? You no need to worry in case if you want to switch from the current company, or in case due to some issue company is getting closed, you want to search outside. No need to worry, because as I said, many projects are running, so many job openings are there. Now let's see how we can set up and setting up of Java environment, and we will go with the programs. So for developing any Java application, we need a Java software, right? That is called JDK, Java Development Kit, right? JDK, it represents basically, you know, what are the tools are required for developing Java thing. So we will see how to download and install JDK, how to set the path environment variable, and if needed, we will see how to download and install Notepad and Eclipse, right? So what you can do is you can go to Google. You can go to Google. Here you can type JDK download for Windows or Linux, right? So as I said, it belongs to Oracle. Now Oracle purchased, and it is paid also for Oracle, but you no need to worry about downloading, you know, Oracle software. Instead, you can download from Zulu. Open JDK, you can type it. Open JDK download, right? There is a, or you can Zulu JDK. Even in companies and all, my projects and all, we are using Zulu. This is open source again. So if you go here, so here you can find out download Zulu, right? There will be different versions, right? So here you can see what is the Java version you are going to download. What is the Java version you are going to download? As I said, current version is Java 15. You can download any version, right? It is better to go with the latest one, or even you can download Java 9 or Java 8, right? Consider, let's go with the latest one, or even if you want, you can go with Java 8. It's up to you. Let's select with Java 8. What is the operating system you want to download? It is Mac or Linux or Windows. Let's go with Windows. It is a 32 bit or 64 bit. Let it be 32 bit, right? Now you can see here, right? One option is there. Either you can download as a zip file, or even you can download and install. Better to download as a zip file, because it is lightweight, right? In case if you are downloading as a MSI installer, again you need to install it, right? Those things are tough. So once you download it, so you will be getting software something like this, right? Let me open it. You will be getting something like this, right? You can extract it. Once you extract it, then you will be getting like this. This is the extracted folder. This is the download folder, right? After downloading, you can extract it. This is the extracted folder, right? Now, once we download, we can just start developing our application. So let's open command prompt. Let's find out what is the Java version we have installed. You can type Java hyphen version. You are getting one issue here. Java is not recognized as an internal or external command. It means you have downloaded the software, but Windows not able to identify that software. We need to make sure Windows should be able to identify the JDK software which we have downloaded. For that purpose, we need to set the path environment variable. So how to set the path environment variable? It is simple. So you can go to start menu. This is very important. You can go to start menu, type environment variables, edit environment variables, right? Here you will be going it, right? Now, in edit environment variables, what you need to do is, there is environment variables option is there. Click it. You will be getting one window, something like this, right? One window you will be getting. So here you can click new, right? You can type Java underscore home. Here you just provide what is the location of JDK you have downloaded and extracted. This is the location, right? C colon software. This is the location. Don't go inside bin. Go up. Go to the main directory. Copy this location and paste it here. That's all. Java home you set. Now you just go to path. There is a path here. Here inside bin only you are having all the things like Java C, Java. Java C is mainly used for compiling the source code, right? Java is for running the program. Jar is for making the jar file, right? Java documentation for preparing the documentation. There are many tools are there. So we need to make sure it is pointing inside thing. Just go to Java home, copy this variable name. I'm copying the variable name. Go inside to path, click new. Just type %, it will take a runtime. Then slash bin, you can type slash bin, small letter. Now what happens whenever you are running Java version, what it will do is it will go to environment variable. It will check what is the path. Path is nothing but Java underscore home slash bin. What is Java underscore home? So in this location, it will go inside bin. It will check whether Java command is there or not. Let's open. Don't again type here. If you type here, again you will get issue. Close this command prompt. Again open command prompt. Now you type java-version. Java-version. Now you can see the version is 14, right? Because when you are typing Java, it is going inside bin directory and seeing is there a command called Java. Yes, there is a command is there, right? Java. So it will use that command. Now you can see the version is Java OpenJDK version 14.01, right? It means your installation is success. You are ready to go with developing Java applications. Now in industry, in our real-time projects, we will be using some of the editors, you can say. Right, one of them is Eclipse, and a few of them is some other is like IntelliJ. Some people they use Eclipse, some people they use IntelliJ. So we can mostly people use Eclipse. So you can say like Eclipse download, right? Eclipse download for Windows. If you need for Windows, you can go here. So it will take you to official Eclipse website. So you can go here. Again, here the Eclipse IDE version is this one. You can just click download. Then it will download one zip file. Then you can extract the zip file. Or even MSI installer also you can easily install. That is not the big thing. So once you install the Eclipse, I'm not installing it because it will be the straightforward. Once you install the Eclipse, then like, you can start developing your Java application. So consider like I have installed the Eclipse. I'm opening the Eclipse software here. Here we will see how we can develop the programs using Eclipse. Here you can give some, workspace, I can say any workspace name. You can say, I can say my workspace. you can open the Eclipse. So Eclipse is opening. Hey, few people are asking about the main course, you know. So let me give some introduction about the main course, then we can go with the coding part. Okay. So you may wonder, like, you know, you may be interested with, you know, how I can join with the main course. So there are some of the things I would like to say to you guys, right? So as I said, I'm a software engineer. So, and also I am teaching around past 3 to 4 years, I am teaching Java related technologies like Java, Core Java, Spring, Hibernate, even AWS, Selenium automation course. So like, you know, I can give few things. So one thing is that when you are learning Java, you cannot jump directly, you know, into Java and start learning it, right? Because there are many topics are there. There are many topics are there. So you need to go step by step, right? Say for example, this is our syllabus, right? So without class and object, right? Without class and object, you cannot learn constructor. Without class and object, you cannot learn abstract class. You cannot learn inheritance. You cannot learn collection API. So all the topics are interdependent, I can say. So we have designed the syllabus such a way that, you know, step by step. First, we will be walking through you like how to download and install, how to develop a few programs, then like, you know, operators, then like static global variables, classes and objects, very in depth. So all the topics, right? Very in depth, we will be walking through. So let me give some information about this course. So what we will do is, I'm the trainer here. So I'll be starting from very basic, consider like you don't have any programming knowledge background. You are from non-computer background, ECE or EEE or commerce background. So I'll be starting from very basic ABCD. So, and I will take you through step by step till advanced level, right? Up to very advanced level, I'll be going through it. And everything I will cover from practical to theory. Everything I can cover from practical to theory. So what you can expect as part of this course, this will be around 2.5 months to 3 months course. Mainly I have designed to crack any product based organizations. So overall I will cover 1000 programs line by line, right? I can open the material and I can show it to you. So this is our material. So it took more time for preparing the material. So you can see number one program, right? 1 to 100 programs. So if you see here, I have started from hello world program. Then like step by step, step by step. For every topic, minimum, you know, 20, 30 programs. Say for example, for unary operators, it started from 23 and it is keep going. For unary operator itself, I have covered up to 44, up to, you know, 20 programs I have covered. Say for example, next topic will be static global variable, right? So you can see static variable one. So from one program up to, if you observe, static variable 25, 26, overall, I have covered up to 30 programs. For each topic, it will be around 30 to 50 programs, right? So like that, I'll be covering like step by step, step by step. All the topics, everything I will cover by programs, step by step. I will open the editor. I will type line by line coding and I will explain, right? So like that, I will be covering around 1000 programs, right? String itself, you can say up to 50 to 60 programs I have covered. So what is my motto is, what my motto is, when you are completing the course, you should be able to get 3 years real-time experience. As I said, I have around 9 years experience. So minimum you should get 3+ years experience knowledge. You can crack, you know, experience level interview even though you are a fresher, right? That is what my motto. So I'll cover around 1,000 programs. As you guys see, all the topics are covered. So along with this, during this course, I will cover real-time things also. Like when we are learning the topic, how we are using at project level, right? So when you are completing, you can clear any OCJP exams, Oracle Certified Programming Exam. And even you can crack, even though you're a fresher, you will be getting 3+ years experience level. So you can crack any, you know, product-based organizations things, product-based organization interviews, you can crack for sure. Many of my students are working people, like 3 years, 5 years working people, developers, Java developers, they are, attending our course. So this is your expectation. What is my expectation? So in case if you want to join the course, you can join the main course. This is a master course and you can attend all the classes without missing. In case if you are missing the class, I'll be providing you the recordings also. Recordings will be available. Daily, you need to practice the programs and inform me. You need to give 100% of your hard work. In 2.5 months, you need to practice. End of the thing, you will be master in the course. So today is one of the demo session. So I'm going to take few more sessions, 13 next Saturday, next to next Saturday and 27th March. Few people are asking about the course details. So as I said, this is a master course, right? This is Core Java. So I will cover 1,000 programs line by line. Duration is, see, first I will start for 1 hour, then it will be going with 1.5 hour, 2 hours. It will be on, I can say 2.5 months approx. Max will be 3 months. And I'm thinking to start in the morning time. You can say 7:32 because many of my students are working people. The value of the course, who knows the value means working people. In case if you're clearing the interview, somehow you are going to the company, you are joining as a Java developer. If you don't know all the topics, it will be tough. You need to work along with that. You need to learn everything. So people, most of my students are working people, 3 years, 5 years, developers, Java developers, they are joining as a students. So, you know, for that purpose, I'm starting from morning 7:30 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. Right? In case if I want to cover more, I will be, you know, extending the timings according to convenient of students, convenient of you guys. And the fees I'm thinking is, you guys can give any rough estimation. So as I said, I need to cover 1,000 programs line by line, everything. But another thing is I always consider is this should be affordable for students. So I'm thinking overall the course fee will be 4,000 rupees. So this is what we have decided. So you can attend the demo sessions. So like, you know, we will not keep following up students for joining the students. No, this is not our approach. Usually we will demonstrate our capacity, our capabilities, what we are doing, how we are doing. In case you guys are really interested, you want to be master in Java, then you can pay the fees and you can join. So, and also we are not worrying about the number. Even in case if we get 10 students or 20 students, that is enough. So we will concentrate only them, we train them. Along with that, we will prepare in interview point of time also. Any other questions you guys have? As few people asked about the details, I have shared the details. So this is a weekday session, Monday to Friday. Overall duration will be 130 hours. It is a 2.5 months course. And course is starting on April 1st. And the fees we are planning is, it is 4,000 rupees. So in case if you are interested, you can WhatsApp me to this number. Let's go ahead with the Eclipse. So as I said, we can just open the Eclipse. And you can give some workspace name here. So let's give here any workspace name. I can give core Java some workspace name. Once you give here Eclipse IDE, so it will generate new workspace for us. So this is the welcome stream, welcome screen. So we can close this. Here you can see left side, you can see like Java project. You can click create Java project. You can give any project name. So I can give core Java. So here you can give what is the JDK version you want to use. So let it be default. You can click finish. So you'll be getting something like this, right? Now you can click right click on SRC directory. Here you can develop, start developing the class. Consider I am going here, my first program. So class name should start with uppercase, right? Class name should start with uppercase. That is the industry standard. Click finish. So you can see here left side one folder is created default. Inside that we can see my first program, right? This is our class here, right? So what I do is let's increase the font size. You can go to Windows preference, font. You can go here, basic text font. We can increase the font size here. Right, yeah. Now if you observe, so this is our class, class name, right? So inside class name, as I said, like we can define the properties, attributes and methods. One of the method is main method. Let's go with public static void main. This takes one single argument called a string array. So I can say string, any name you can give, right? This is a method. Before explaining this method, let's develop some program. Then, you know, we can start explaining about the method. I'm just typing system.out.println. I can say, hey, welcome to Mercy Technologies. Now I have developed it, right? This is my program. How I can run it? It's simple. It is very simple for running the class. Right click, there are many ways. Right click, run as Java application. So you'll be seeing here, output as welcome to Mercy Technologies. Here you are seeing, right? Welcome to Mercy Technologies. Now you can ask like, there are many ways, or directly you can press this button. It will run the program, right? Welcome to Mercy Technologies. I want to print more here. Welcome to Mercy Technologies. Let's learn Java in a fun way, right? Again, you need to save it, run the program. Then you'll be getting output again here. So system.out.println, it is used to print something in the console, right? Whatever you are giving in the double quotes that you are printing it. Now, as I said, everything goes inside class. That's why we are said, you know, that's why you mentioned that Java is object oriented, right? So inside class, you can define any number of methods. This is one of the method, right? I'll try to explain about this method. In case if you understand, if you can able to understand little bit, that is enough. You no need to worry about to understand everything 100% because all things are different topics. This method is a public. It means this method can be accessed by anyone, right? Access modifier is a public. Anyone can access, right? Even outside class also, you are having one more class, my second program. That class also can access this method, right? That class also can call this method. That's why the access level is public. What is the second one? Second one, static. What is meant by static? It means, so as we said, everything goes inside the class. Class consists variables and methods.
And if you see public, this method is public. Anyone can access it. Static means this method belongs to class, not object, right?
Static means it will be available for anyone, right? Void means this method does not return any type. This is the return type, right? And the main is the name of the method. Method can take any argument. So, but so basically, when we are running the class, right? When we are running the class, so JVM comes into picture, right? JVM, Java Virtual Machine, runtime environment comes into picture. When we are running, it needs to know from where I need to start the execution. So it is expecting one method signature, something like this: public, static, void, main. This method should take one string array argument, right? String is a predefined class, one array, string array argument. So runtime environment expects this signature. If you don't give the argument, or if you make any modification in the signature, program will not execute, right? See, we are getting some error. So runtime environment, it is expecting something like this. So we need to go with the same signature. Again, I can explain. Public means this class can accessible anywhere. Anyone can access. So public, it is a separate topic. It comes under access modifier, like private, public, default, and protected. All things are each of them are separate topic. So, you know, when we are seeing in our master course, we will go very in depth. Static means, you know, this method, either the method belongs to class or object or instance. This method, static means it belongs to class. Void is nothing but it, this method is not returning any type. Main is a method name, right? And it is taking single argument, right? So by using inside this method, what we are doing, we are printing some messages. Let's go with one more program. Let's again create one more new class. Go to SRC, right click, new class. You can type any name. You can type class name, can be meaningful. You can type client one. Okay. Again, it is a client one class. So you need to develop main method. So public, static, void, main, right? It is a string array. Now, suppose I want to, you know, do some calculations. Say, for example, int a equal to 10, right? Int b equal to 20. I want to find out the multiplication, right? So how I can do that? It's simple. There are many ways. Either you can define like int c equal to a into b, then you can print the result here, right? Or directly also you can print it. Let's see the things, right? I can say multiplication is c, right? Plus c. So in case we are, if you are using any constant value, you need to delimit something like this using plus. Now let's run the program again. See here, multiplication is 200. Either you can print something like this. When we are running the program, that time runtime environment comes into picture. It looks a method with this signature and started executing from main method. Or even without storing like this, you can directly use something like this, right? This is also possible, right? Let's run this program again. See here, multiplication is 2000. Is it clear, guys, how to develop Hello World program? So as part of this session, we have seen like Core Java introduction, why we need to learn Core Java, what are the benefits we are getting, real-time usage of Core Java in IT companies, and we have seen how to set up the Java environment, like how to download the necessary softwares, how to set the path environment variable, and you know, finally, we have seen a couple of example programs, how to develop a sample programs, how to compile it, how to run the program.